Hi all, welcome to the third part of the lecture on heat exchangers. In the first part, we mainly discussed various classification of heat exchangers. And in the second part, we have done four important derivations while discussing the analysis of heat exchangers. First, we have derived LMTD expressions and then the effectiveness expressions for both parallel and counterflow arrangements. Today, we are going to discuss some numerical problems in this topic. Let's move on to the first problem. Let me read the question first. The flow rates of hot and cold water streams running through a parallel flow heat exchanger are 0.2 kilogram per second and 0.5 kilogram per second respectively. The inlet temperatures on hot and cold flow sides are 75 degrees Celsius and 20 degrees Celsius respectively. The exit temperature of hot water is 45 degrees Celsius. If the individual heat transfer coefficients on both sides are 650 watt per meter square degree Celsius, calculate the area of heat transfer. Take Cp value for water for both hot and cold fluids is equal to 4.18 kilojoule per kilogram degree Celsius. We should draw the temperature profile first and mark all the given temperatures here. We know the heat transfer equation for a heat exchanger is Q is equal to U A theta M. This is the heat transfer equation, where U is the overall heat transfer coefficient, A is the heat transfer area, and theta M is the LMTD. Okay, logarithmic mean temperature difference. From this equation, we can calculate the heat transfer area. To find theta M, we need all four temperatures, that is inlet and exit temperature of hot fluid and inlet and exit temperature of cold fluid. Okay, in this problem they have given inlet temperature of hot and cold fluid and exit temperature of hot fluid only. This temperature is unknown, exit temperature of cold fluid is unknown. We know that theta M is equal to theta 1 minus theta 2 divided by ln of theta 1 by theta 2, where theta 1 is the inlet temperature difference of hot and cold fluid, and theta 2 is the exit temperature difference of hot and cold fluids. Okay, so first we need to find TC2. To find TC2, apply energy balance equation between hot and cold fluid. We know that heat loss by the hot fluid is MHCPH TH1 minus TH2. That should be equal to the heat gain by the cold fluid, that is MCCPC TC2 minus TC1. So by equating these two equations, you can find TC2, because the only unknown is TC2. MCCPC, MHCPH, TH1, TH2 and TC1, all these data are given. Okay, this is the heat transfer rate in this heat exchanger, MHCPH TH1 minus TH2, that is mass flow rate of hot fluid is 0.2 kilogram per second and Cp value is 4.187 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin, and this is the temperature difference in inlet and out exit temperature of hot fluid. So you will get the heat transfer rate as 25.122 kilojoule per second or kilowatt. So equate this value with the MCCPC TC2 minus TC1, you can calculate TC2. TC2 is equal to 32 degree Celsius. Okay. Now you can calculate LMTD, that is equal to theta 1 minus theta 2 divided by ln of theta 1 by theta 2. That is equal to theta 1 is 75 minus 20, that is 55, and theta 2 is 45 minus TC2 is 32. that is 13. So ln of 55 divided by 13, you will get LMTD, or for the given parallel flow heat exchanger, is equal to 29.12 degrees Celsius. Now we need to find U value, overall heat transfer coefficient. Q heat transfer rate already we have calculated, theta m we have already calculated. Now if you want if you find U value, we can calculate area, okay, from this equation. So from data book page number 165, you can find the overall heat transfer coefficient equation, that is U equal to, this is corresponding to the outside outer surface area of the tube. Okay, in this problem actually they are not given it is a tube into heat exchanger, or the inlet and outlet radius of a tube, or the thermal conductivity of the tube material, nothing is given here. Only the given value here is the heat transfer coefficients on both sides, on cold fluid side and hot fluid side, HI and HO. Here this term represents the fouling factor, RFI and RFO. Fouling corresponding to inside of the tube and corresponding to the outside of the tube, and nothing is given regarding the tube material and inlet and outlet radius of heat exchanger. You can neglect these terms. This term is represented conduction resistance through the tube. This term represents the RF, the fouling factor at inside. This term represents fouling factor at the outer surface, and this term R0 by RI, this term is also neglected. So you will get the remaining U0 is equal to 1 by U is equal to 1 by HI plus 1 by HO, 1 by HI plus 1 by HO only. Okay, so you can calculate U overall heat transfer coefficient by using this equation. You will get it as 325 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So you can calculate the area of heat exchanger. A is equal to Q by U into theta m. You will get 2.65 meter square. The next problem, a 2 shell passes and 4 2 passes heat exchanger is used to, it is a multi-pass shell and tube heat exchanger. Okay. Heat glycerin from 20 degree Celsius to 50 degree Celsius by hot water. So glycerin is the cold water, cold fluid, and water is the hot fluid. So hot water endates the thin walled 2 cm diameter tube at 80 degree Celsius and leaves at 40 degree Celsius. So hot fluid inlet and exit temperature is given, and cold fluid inlet and exit temperature is also given. The total length of the tubes in the heat exchanger is 60 meter. Total length of the tube is given. The convection heat transfer coefficient is 25 watt per meter square degree Celsius on glycerin side, where glycerin is on the shell side, and 160 watt per meter square degree Celsius on the water side. Water is on the tube side. Water is moving through the tube and glycerin is moving through the shell. Determine the rate of heat transfer in the heat exchanger in these two cases. Okay, first case is before any fouling occurs, it is a new heat exchanger, and after fouling with fouling factor of 0.006 meter square degree Celsius per watt. So this is the fouling factor given, occurs on the outer surface of the tube. So this is the problem. This is the figure of the heat exchanger. We have 2 shell passes and we have 4 tube passes. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 tube passes. So it is a 2 shell pass, 4 tube pass heat exchanger. Shell and tube heat exchanger. If it is a multi-pass heat exchanger, the LMTD we can calculate by finding a correction factor corresponding to the given heat exchanger by using the correction factor chart from the data book. Page number 168, you can find two shall pass, 4, 8, 12, etc. Any multiple of 4, 2 passes. By using this chart, you can calculate the correction factor. And this correction factor multiplied with the LMTD for counterflow heat exchanger will give you the LMTD of a multi-pass heat exchanger. And you can calculate the heat transfer rate by using this equation UAS F delta T LM counterflow. So to find the delta T LM or theta M for a counterflow heat exchanger, draw the temperature profile first. Water is on the tube side and the glycerin is on the shell side. So this is a tube side, water, hot water is on the tube side, cold glycerin is on the shell side. So all these four temperatures are given. You can calculate theta 1 by using this. So by drawing this, you can easily find out what is theta 1 and what is theta 2. So always, it is very important, always draw the temperature profile of the heat exchanger. All these temperatures are given, where theta 1 is equal to, for a counterflow heat exchanger, theta 1 is equal to the temperature difference between inlet temperature of hot fluid minus exit temperature of cold fluid, that is theta 1. Okay, so you can calculate theta 1, theta 2, and you can calculate counterflow heat exchanger theta M LMTD. You will get it as 24.7 degrees Celsius. Now, from data book page number 168, you can calculate or you can read the correction factor by calculating two temperature, dimensionless temperature times, that is P and R. You can see P is on the X axis and correction factor is on the Y axis in this chart. Okay, and R values are given by these curves. Okay, these curves are constant R value curves. So P, from this chart, it is clear that from this figure, temperature, small letter T1 and T2 represent tube side fluid, and capital T1 and capital T2 represents the temperatures, inlet and exit temperatures of shell side fluid. So P is the ratio small T2 minus T1 divided by capital T1 minus small T1. In this problem, small T2 and small T1, tube side temperatures, in this hot fluid is in the tube side. So T2, small T2 is 40 degrees Celsius, small T1 is 80 degrees Celsius. So 40 minus 80 divided by capital T1 is a shell side inlet temperature, that is 20 degrees Celsius, 20 minus 80, T1 is 80. So you will get 0.67, and also you have the equation for dimensionless term R is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T2 minus T1, small T2 minus T1. Capital T1 and T2 is 20 and 50, so 20 minus 50 divided by small T2 minus T1, small T2 is 40, small T1 is 80, so 40 minus 80, you will get 0.75. Now, corresponding to the P value 0.67 and the R value 0.75, you can read the correction factor on the Y axis. You will get it as 0.91. You can see P value is on the X axis, that is 0.67. So this is 0.6, this is 0.7, this is 0.65. So you can draw a vertical line here. So this is 0.67. 0.67 vertical line, and the R value is 0.75. Here you can see the curve, constant R value curves, 0.6, 0.8. So 0.75, 0.75 is nearer to this 0.8 curve. So it will be somewhere here. So both this vertical line and this curve will meet somewhere here. You can draw a horizontal line here, so you will get the correction factor as 0.91. So once you got correction factor F, now we need to find U and AS. To find the surface area of heat exchanger, they have given the length of the tube as 60 meter and the diameter of the tube as 0.02 meter. So you can calculate surface area of the heat exchanger by using this equation, As equal to pi dl, that is equal to, you will get 3.77 meter square. It is given as thin walled tube, so we can neglect the conduction resistance through the wall. Now, this is our overall heat transfer coefficient equation. In this equation, if it is thin walled, so we can neglect this term. There is no fouling, you can neglect this term and this term. No fouling is there at inside and outside surface. And because it is thin walled tube, there is no conduction resistance. So you can neglect this term also. The remaining equation will be U0 equal to 1 by hi plus 1 by ho. 1 by hi is the heat transfer coefficient at inside, and ho is the heat transfer coefficient the outside of the tube, that is on shell side. Okay, both values are given, so you can calculate U value 21.6 watt per meter square Kelvin. Okay, so by using this equation, Q is equal to UAS F delta TLM CF, okay, counter flow. You will get the heat transfer rate without fouling is equal to 1830 watt. The fouling factor is given at the outer side of the tube, and conduction resistance we have neglected because it is a thin wall, and inside there is no fouling. So we can use this equation, 1 by hi plus RFO. RFO is there in this case, plus 1 by ho. So you will get U is equal to 21.3 watt per meter square Kelvin. By using this equation, you will get the heat transfer rate. The total heat transfer rate is equal to 1805 watt. Go to the third problem. Calculate for the following cases the surface area required for a heat exchanger which is required to cool 3200 kilogram per hour of benzene. Its CP value is given 1.74 kilojoule per kilogram degree Celsius, from 72 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius. Okay, so inlet and outlet temperature is given, CP value is given, mass flow rate is given in case of benzene. So it is required to cool. So benzene is the hot fluid. The cooling water, its CP value is given at 15 degree Celsius, has a flow rate of 2200 kilogram per hour. Indicates the heat exchanger. So cold fluid inlet temperature is given, exit temperature is not given. So for these cases, for these three cases, find the heat transfer surface area. First one is single pass counterflow heat exchanger. Second, 2-4 heat exchanger. 2-4 heat exchanger means 2 shell pass and 4 tube pass. Then a cross flow single pass with water mixed and benzene unmixed. It is a one fluid mixed, other fluid unmixed case. They have also given the overall heat transfer coefficient for all these cases as 0.28 kilowatt per meter square degree Celsius. Always careful about the units. So these are the given values. MH is corresponding for benzene. These values are given, MH, CPH, TH1, TH2. So you can calculate the heat transfer rate directly. You should convert this MH value into kilogram per second. It is given 3200 kilogram per hour. So you should convert it to kilogram per second. Then MC also given in kilogram per hour. So convert it to kilogram per second. Then CP, TC1 is given, but TC2 is not given. TC2 is unknown, and U value is also given. So you should find 0.28 kilowatt. So it will be 280 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Now first find out by TC2, exit temperature of cold fluid, then only we can calculate the theta m value by energy balance equation. Here MH, CPH, TH1 minus TH2 is equal to MCCPC, TC2 minus TC1. This is the energy balance equation here. So you can calculate TC2 first, which is 33.2 degree Celsius, and Q value you can calculate directly which will be 46.4 kilowatt. Now the first case, for a single pass counterflow heat exchanger, find theta m value. Theta, for finding theta m value, first you draw the counterflow heat exchanger temperature profile, okay, and mark all the temperatures here, so you can easily find out what is theta 1 and theta 2. Here theta 1 is TH1 minus TC2, that is 72 minus 33.2, and theta 2 is 42 minus 15. You can use this equation. This is the LMTD equation for counterflow, okay, single pass. So you will get 32.5 degrees Celsius. Now to find surface area of the first case, single pass counterflow heat exchanger, use this equation. Q is equal to U theta M into A. Q value we have already calculated, U is given, and theta M is also calculated. You can, only unknown is surface area A. So you, A is equal to, you will get 5.1 meter square. Now to find 2 to 4 heat exchanger theta M, you need to calculate the correction factor. So for this case, you need to calculate P value and R value here. So in this problem, it is not given which fluid is passing through the shell side and which fluid is passing through the tube side. So we should assume, so assume water is on the tube side and benzene is on the shell side. Water is the cold fluid and benzene is the hot fluid here. So small T2 and T1 represents the tube side temperatures, and capital T1 and capital T2 represents the shell side temperatures. So if water is on the tube side, then TC, T2 and T1 is 33.2 minus 15, and T1 is benzene is on shell side. Okay, so T1 is 72 and T2, capital T2, is 42. So you can calculate these values, P and R values. You will get 0.32 is P value and 1.65 is R value, corresponding to these two values from page number 168. Page number 168 in the data book, you can calculate the correction factor, which will be 0.97. So calculate the area of this heat exchanger, 2 to 4 heat exchanger, you will get 5.26 meter square. Now for the cross flow heat exchanger, in this case, from page number 169, you can see the chart, okay, for finding correction factor. Thus that chart, they have given a picture of the heat exchanger. So it is clear that capital T1 and capital T2, from that figure we can read, capital T1 and capital T2 is the temperatures of the mixing fluid. In this case, water is mixed, so the temperatures, inlet and exit temperatures of water, is capital T1 and capital T2, and unmixed cases, small T1 and small T2. Okay, so in our problem, benzene is unmixed, unmixed. So small T1 is equal to 72 degrees Celsius and small T2 is equal to 42 degrees Celsius. So you can calculate P and R value corresponding to these temperatures. You will get 0.53 and 0.61. And from that chart, you can read the correction factor. You will get 0.92. And then calculate the surface area of the heat exchanger. Using this equation, you will get 5.54 meter square. Now, next problem. This is a very important problem. Water at the rate of 4 kg per second is heated from 38 degrees Celsius to 55 degrees Celsius in a shell and tube heat exchanger. The water is to flow inside tubes of 2 cm diameter with an average velocity of 35 cm per second. Centimeter per second. Careful about the unit. Hot water available at 95 degrees Celsius and at the rate of 2 kg per second is used as the heating medium on shell side. So hot water is on shell side, and on tube side cold water is there. If the length of the tubes must not be more than 2 meter, calculate number of tube passes the number of tubes per pass and the length of the tube for one pass shell. That means the shell length, assuming U is equal to 1500 watt per meter square Kelvin on outer surface. Okay, U out. Here, these are the values in tube side. They have given MC. Tube side, cold water is flowing. So MC is equal to 4 kilogram per second, TC1, TC2. And its diameter of the tube is given. Velocity of the tube is given. It is 35 centimeter second, converted to meter per second, 0.35. And diameter is also given centimeter, 2 centimeter. So it will be 0.02 meter. And length of the tube is also given as 2 meter. So we need to find the number of tubes per pass. Let it denoted with the letter capital M. And the mass flow rate is given in case of tube fluid, that is 4 kilogram per second. We know that mass flow rate is equal to rho AV multiplied with the number of tubes. This A is a cross section area or flow area of a single tube. AC is a cross section area of a single tube. From this equation, rho is, we know the fluid is water, so it is 1000 and velocity is given as 0.35 meter per second. So corresponding to this mass flow rate and this velocity and this area, area is also, you can calculate the area because the diameter is given, of the tube is given. We need 37 tubes for the given mass flow rate. Initially, we assume one tube pass and one shell pass. We know that heat transfer Q is equal to U AS theta M, where this AS is the surface area of the heat exchanger. Okay, so you have the equation U is equal to surface area is pi dl into number of tubes. Pi dl for one tube into number of tubes. Okay, that is N into theta M is the heat transfer rate equation. By using this equation, we can calculate the length of the tube. We have a restriction here. The length of the tubes must not be more than 2 meter. Find the theta M considering the heat exchanger as counterflow heat exchanger. Okay, all these four temperatures are given. So calculate theta M first by using this equation for a counterflow heat exchanger. So it's TH2, hot fluid outer temperature is not given in this case. So find that value first by using energy balance on either side. Okay, all other values are given. So you can calculate TH2 first. Once you get TH2, you can calculate theta 1 and theta 2 and calculate theta M. So you will get 30.72 degrees Celsius as theta M. Now we have a heat transfer equation MCCPCTC2-TC1 on cold side that should be equal to the total heat transfer rate through the heat exchanger, that is U AS theta M. So that should be equal to 284240 watt. By using this equation, you can calculate this one. So you can calculate the total heat transfer area, surface area of the heat transfer, by equating this equation. So you will get 6.17 meter square. We know that surface area of the heat exchanger is pi dl to n. You already calculated the number of tubes corresponding to the mass flow rate. So by substituting that value here, and pi d is also given, area is also calculated. So you can calculate the length of the tube for a single pass. Here we assume that one passes on the tube. Okay, only one tube pass. But calculating L value, it will be 2.65 meter. It is more than that of the allowed 2 meter. So there is more than single pass through the tubes. Okay, so we take it as two tube passes and one shell pass heat exchanger and recalculate. Again, calculate the length of the tube. Okay, total length of the tube. If it is a multi-pass heat exchanger, we should find the correction factor, which is in the page number 167 of the data book. Okay, here shell side and tube side fluids are given. So by using the temperatures, we can calculate P value and R value, and you will get corresponding both these values, you will get F is equal to 0.88. Okay, now we have Q is equal to UAS F theta M. F theta M, that should be equal to this the same heat transfer rate. Okay, so you can calculate the surface area corresponding for a two pass one shell pass heat exchanger, that is 7.01 meter square. So by equating that value with this equation pi d l n, you will get the total length of the tube, that is equal to 3.02 meter. Now, since the number of tube passes is 2, length of the tubes per pass, that means shell length, okay, is given by length of tube per number of passes, that is equal to 3.02 divided by 2, you will get 1.51 meter. Okay, so 1.51 meter is the length of the tube per pass or shell length. Number of tube per pass we have already calculated 37 tubes, and the number of tube passes is equal to 2. Problem number 5, saturated steam at 120 degree Celsius condenses on the outer tube surface of a single pass heat exchanger. So it is a condenser, it's a special type heat exchanger. Determine the surface area to heat 1000 kilogram per hour of water from 20 degree Celsius to 90 degree Celsius. So we need to find the surface area, okay, of the heat exchanger. Find the mass of the condensate. Also we need to find the mass of the condensate. Okay, so take U is equal to 1800 watt per meter square degree Celsius, and HFG is also given. HFG is the latent heat of condensation, that is equal to 2200 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, so by drawing the condenser temperature profile, in a condenser hot fluid is having phase change, so its temperature will not change. Okay, so steam is condensing at 120 degree Celsius. Okay, and but the cold fluid, that is water, which is heated up from 20 degree Celsius to 90 degree Celsius, it is given in the question. Okay, so this is the theta 1 and this is theta 2. Okay, so theta 1 and theta 2 we can calculate, and you can calculate the theta M value, which is 58.14 degree Celsius. Now we can calculate the heat transfer rate by using this equation MCCPC TC2 minus TC1, that is equal to 81.39 kilowatt. We have the equation for heat exchanger. Q is equal to UA theta M. This equation you can find from the data book. Okay, this from this equation Q, U and theta M, Q, U and theta M, we know only unknown is A. So area of the heat exchanger is, you will get 0.78 meter square. Okay, now the other question is, find the mass of condensate. Mass of condensate. So we know that Q is equal to, for a phase change process, for a phase change process, heat transfer rate Q is equal to mass of condensate multiplied with its latent heat of condensation per kilogram. Okay, it is given as 2200, so you can calculate mass of condensate. Okay, the heat transfer rate is already calculated, that is 81.39 kilowatt. Okay, so 81.39 divided by 2200, you will get 0.0307 kilogram per second as the condensation of steam, condensation rate of steam. Okay, so in kilogram per hour is 133.2 kilogram per kilogram of steam is condensing per hour to heat 20 degree Celsius water to 90 degree Celsius. Okay, next problem is a evaporator type problem. Evaporator, okay, a parallel flow heat exchanger is designed as an evaporator in which oil is cooling from oil. This is oil, hot fluid is oil. Oil is cooling from 100 degree Celsius to 40 degree Celsius, while water evaporates at constant temperature of 20 degree Celsius. The heat transfer surface consists of 25 meter long tube of 25 mm inside diameter. The oil is flowing at a velocity of 0.6 meter per second. Calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient for the heat exchanger. Take Cp oil is equal to 2.5 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin, and the specific gravity of the oil is S is equal to 0.8. Okay, here also you can draw the temperature profile for a evaporator. For an evaporator, the cold fluid having phase change, so its temperature is same during the phase change process. Okay, so it is given as 20 degree Celsius, and the hot fluid is giving heat. Okay, so it is continuously cooling from 100 degree Celsius to 40 degree Celsius. Okay, so all the inlet and exit temperatures are there. You can calculate theta 1 and theta 2, and you can calculate the theta m value. Okay, theta m you can calculate. You will get 43.28 degree Celsius as theta m. Now, here the mass flow rate is not given directly. Mass flow rate of hot fluid is not given directly. Okay, so they have given the specific heat of the oil, specific gravity of the oil, and Cp of oil. Okay, and then the velocity of the oil is also given, and the diameter of the tube is also given, right? Okay, cross section area, diameter of the tube is also given. Okay, here this is the diameter of the 25 mm long tube of 25 mm inside dia. Okay, tube is also given, right? So you can calculate the mass flow rate of the hot fluid, that is oil. So rho AV, that is the mass flow rate equation. Here rho is not given, instead they have given the specific gravity. So specific gravity multiplied with the density of water will give you the density of the oil. Okay, so 0.8 into 1000, that is the density of oil. A is the cross section area, that is pi by 4 d square, multiplied the velocity of the oil. Velocity of the oil is given as 0.6 meter per second. So you can calculate mh. Okay, oil, mass flow rate of oil, which is 0.2356 kilogram per second. Now total heat removed from the oil is equal to mh cph th1 minus th2. All these values we know now, so you can calculate the heat transfer rate, 35.34 kilowatt. Okay, LMTD we have already calculated. Now by using this equation you can calculate the U value. Here Q is equal to U A LMTD, where A is the surface area. Surface area we can calculate by using this equation, pi d L. Okay, so L is also given, that is 25 meter long tube is also given. So Q is there, U we need to calculate, pi is there, D is there, L is there, theta m is there. You can calculate U value. Okay, you will get 415.97 watt per meter Kelvin. That is the overall heat transfer coefficient for the given heat exchanger. Okay, The next problem is corresponding to effectiveness NTU method. Here, the water at a rate of 7000 kilogram per hour enters a counterflow heat exchanger at 20 degrees Celsius to cool 6000 kilogram per hour of air at 90 degrees Celsius. So air is a hot fluid and water is the cold fluid. Okay, the overall heat transfer coefficient is given 130 watt per meter square Kelvin, and the heat exchanger area is given as 20 meter square. Calculate the exit temperatures of the air. So in this problem you can notice that both exit temperatures are not given. So this problem we can't solve by using LMTD method. Okay, so here if both exit temperatures are unknown, use the effectiveness NTU method to solve the problem. So in this case, mass flow rate of cold fluid is given 7000 kilogram per hour converted to kilogram per second. TC1 is given, CPC is given, it is not given actually, you know this value because it is water, 4.18 into 10 raised to 3 joule per kilogram Kelvin, that is Cp value. U is given, AA is given. On hot side, air side, MH is given, converted to kilogram per second. Then TH1 is given and CPH is given. Okay, so we know that the in the effectiveness NTU method, effectiveness is equal to Q actual by Q max, where Q actual is MH CPH TH1 minus TH2 or MC CPC TC2 minus TC1 divided by Q max. Q max is C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. This is the maximum possible temperature difference in any heat exchanger, TH1 minus TC1. Okay, so C minimum is MC CPC or MH CPH, whichever is minimum. So first calculate CH and CC. CH is equal to MH CPH. You will get 1.675 into 10 raised to 3 watt per Kelvin. And CC is equal to MC CPC, that is equal to 8.12 into 10 raised to 3 watt per meter Kelvin. So among these two values, CH is C minimum and CC is C max. Now we know that NTU is equal to UA by C minimum. From page number 161, you can find the equation for NTU and R. NTU is equal to UA by C minimum and R is equal to C minimum C max. You can calculate this value because UA and C minimum, all these values are given. C minimum and C max is also we have calculated. So you can calculate NTU and R. So now from the data book, page number 161, corresponding to a counterflow heat exchanger, effectiveness equation is given. Effectiveness for counterflow heat exchanger is equal to 1 minus exponential of minus NTU into 1 minus R. In data book it is denoted with the C, okay, capital C. Okay, 1 minus e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus C divided by 1 minus C into e raised to minus NTU into 1 minus C for a counterflow heat exchanger. Calculate the effectiveness equation. We have all the values NTU and R, okay, for C. Okay, you will get effectiveness is equal to 0.753. Now we need to find out the outlet temperature of air. Air is a hot fluid, so use this equation. Effectiveness is equal to Q actual by Q max, that is equal to MH CPH TH1 minus TH2. Okay, we need to calculate the exit temperature of air. In this problem, air is the hot fluid, so use this equation divided by C minimum into TH1 minus TC1. Here in this problem, the MH CPH is the C minimum value, so you can cancel these two values. Then it's a matter of time. You can calculate TH2 is equal to 37.3 degrees Celsius by equating effectiveness. We have already calculated 0.753. Okay, so you will get TH2 is equal to 37.3 degrees Celsius. Next, the last problem. This is also an effectiveness NTU method problem. Hot water having specific heat 4200 joule per kilogram Kelvin flows through a heat exchanger at the rate of 4 kilogram per minute. Careful, the unit. Okay, with an inlet temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. A cold fluid having specific heat 2400 joule per kilogram Kelvin flows in at a rate of 8 kilogram per minute and with inlet temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. So both fluids inlet temperature is given, mass flow rate is given, and specific heat also given. Make calculations for the maximum possible effectiveness if the fluid flow is parallel flow and second case counter flow. Okay, so both cases we need to find the effectiveness value. Okay, here the hot fluid is water but the cold fluid is unknown. Okay, and in this case these are the given values on water side, that is hot fluid side, and on cold fluid side these are the given values. MCCPC TC1 is given, MHCPH TH1 is given. So for a parallel flow heat exchanger, from page number 161 you will get this equation: 1 minus exponential of minus NTU into 1 plus C divided by 1 plus C, where NTU is equal to UA by C minimum. In this case a area of the heat exchanger is not given, so assume it a unit area. Assume a unit area. C minimum we can calculate by calculating MHCPH and MCCPC. Okay, but the U, overall heat transfer coefficient, is not given here. So you can find the overall heat transfer coefficient from the data book. Okay, refer page number 164. There we have a table. In that table they have page number 164, they have given some approximate overall heat transfer coefficients for preliminary estimates. Okay, so overall heat transfer coefficient for different duties, they have given different duties: water to compressed air, water to water, water to lubricative oil, etc. So we need, what are the fluids? Hot fluid is which one and cold fluid is which one? In our problem, hot fluid is water, it is given, so water to some other fluid. That cold fluid is unknown here, so we need to identify which is that fluid. Okay, so let's check with its CP value. To identify the cold fluid, check for CP value nearer to 2400 joule per kilogram Kelvin corresponding to 20 degree Celsius. In the data book, from page number 30 to 33, they have given different property values of fluids in saturated state. So let's check the near CP value of 2400 joule per kilogram Kelvin. So if we check from page number 30 to 33, you can find two fluids having CP almost equal to 2400 at 20 degree Celsius. Okay, from page number 31 you have glycerin, which CP value is equal to 2387 joule per kilogram Kelvin at 20 degree Celsius. From page number 33 you can find ethylene glycol, the CP value is 2382 joule per kilogram Kelvin at 20 degree Celsius. So our cold fluid is one of this. Okay, so now let's go to page number 164. Choose U value corresponding to water to organic solvents or alcohol, because both of the above liquids, that is glycerin and ethylene glycol, both these liquids are organic compounds. So our duty is water to organic solvent or alcohol. Okay, so our cold fluid is an organic solvent or alcohol. In that table it is given a range, water to organic solvent, it is ranging from, U values ranging from 390 to 900. So either you can calculate its average value or you can choose any value within the within this range, 390, in between 390 to 900. Okay, let's take the average here and calculate CH value and CC value by multiplying MHCPH and MCCPC. So from these both values, MHCPH is C minimum and MCCPH is C max. So you can calculate NTU and C or capital R. Okay, each are 2.29 and 0.882. Okay, now just substitute these values in the equations of effectiveness for parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger. Both these equations you can find from the page number 161. Okay, you will get effectiveness of parallel flow heat exchanger is 0.524 and effectiveness for counter flow heat exchanger is 0.725. I have included some practice questions. Do it yourself at home. These are the reference textbooks, Heat and Mass Transfer by Incorpora and DeWitt, Heat Transfer by UNS Essential, and Heat and Mass Transfer by RK Rajput. Thank you all.